lunchtime restorative yoga. Now, restorative yoga is yoga designed to completely relax the nervous system. And so we're going to use some things to help support the body so that we can relax physically, and then hopefully the nervous system will respond by relaxing as well. So the props that we're going to use today are props that I think you can find, most of us will probably have in our homes, or at least something fairly close. So you're going to need a chair if you want to do a legs up the wall kind of variation at the very end. Have a chair handy. You're also going to need a blanket, and if you can do it, two throw pillows. Okay. If you don't have throw pillows but you've got yoga blocks, you can use those instead. But the throw pillows are nicer, they're a little softer. So that's what we're going to use for today's practice. A chair at the very end, that's optional, but if you have one, cool. A blanket. Any blanket will do, as long as you can fold it or roll it. And two pillows. So grab those things, and then we'll get started. I'm going to move my chair out of the way a little bit. Now, the first part is to fold your blanket really evenly. And one of the things about restorative yoga that is important is a little bit of precision. So we're going to fold the blanket up. So start, like, if your blanket, this is how big my blanket is to start with. It would cover the top of like a full-size bed, maybe almost a whole queen-size bed, but not much bigger than that. Okay, so I'm going to fold it in half. Now, I sometimes start long ways, but usually I fold it in half so that the longer ends come together. Okay? Now, this is a wool blanket, and one of the things that happens to wool blankets over time is that they, because they're mostly it's made of felt, right? It's mostly a felted kind of blanket, is they kind of morph their shape. So if you have a woven blanket, yours might be a little bit more precise, but you're just going to get it as close as you can. So bring the edges together so that you folded it in half one time, and then what I do is I go to the folded edge and try to smooth that edge out. And that way, if the ends aren't completely even, it won't matter as much because that's going to go away from my skin anyway. Okay, so I folded it once, then I'm going to fold it in half, bringing the longest edges together. And again, I'm going to go to the folded edges and make those as neat as possible, and everything else hopefully will kind of fall into place as best it can. Some blankets have fringes, and so you just want the fringes, again, to be on the edge that's not, you're not paying as much attention to. You're going to pay attention to the folded edges. Okay, so now I have my blanket pretty close to where I think I'm going to need it for this first pose. Now, some of us are going to like a bigger surface under our back, and some people are going to like it much smaller. So one possibility is to go ahead and fold it one more time and then roll it up into like basically thirds, okay? And that will give you quite a lot of support under your back. It'll be a back bend almost akin to a little baby cobra. Now, for those of us that might not want quite that much, you could leave it one size bigger and roll it up that way. And you can roll it up like you roll up a sleeping bag, where you really tightly fold it and kind of smooth and fold and smooth and fold. But for me, that can be a little bit too abusive. So my preference is to do a softer kind of thing. So I fold it that I've got something that's about somewhere between 4 and 6 inches wide, and then I just keep going like that. So it's a little bit softer. And for me, that is usually better. And then the third possibility, and that's either of these options, but the third possibility is to roll it so that you only roll up about half of it. Okay? And then your head will rest on the end of the blanket, and this will go under your back. So depending on how sensitive you find yourself, you're going to fiddle with the blanket to get just right. And then have your pillows nearby, because those you might want to put under your legs. You might not. Okay, so we're going to lay back. back over this blanket. And we want the blanket to go pretty much right at the bottom of the shoulder blade. So if I drew a line from my sternum straight down, it would intersect the blanket. The arm should be on top, and then I'm going to tuck the shoulder blades underneath me. Okay? Now, initially, this feels pretty strange, right? Because I'm in a back bend, and especially if you've been leaning over a computer or something like that, this will feel very weird. So you might decide to give it a second and see if it softens. And if it really doesn't soften, try some other version of this blanket situation. Some of us will be happy having the legs completely stretched out, and then some of us might be happier with a little support. So you take a throw pillow, and then a throw pillow, and put those under your legs. You might have to fiddle with how close they are to your hip, and then you can relax. Now, sometimes I like a cactus, but if your arms don't rotate all the way and your hand pokes up in the air like that, try a T instead, okay? And if you're like me and you're working around your plant stands, you're just gonna pick it. Another option is to bring the arms all the way over your head, almost like you're gonna cup your elbows, but not quite. And for some people, that's more comfortable. For me, it's better to have a cactus or a T, okay? Shape with the arms, okay. So then once you've got yourself settled, now already for me, this has softened. And the initial kind of discomfort I had laying over this blanket is pretty much gone. I feel the blanket, but there's not anything that's making me feel uncomfortable or fidgety. Take a deep breath and let yourself let go with a sigh. We're gonna just settle in. Now we're gonna stay with this pose for about 4 or 5 more minutes. This one can be a little bit spicy. Sometimes I like to do it for as long as 10, but for today we're gonna do just a few more. But try to let yourself consciously relax all the muscles in your body. So you might start like up near your forehead, sort of pay attention to how the tension might be around your temples and around the sides of the ears, and see if you can release any tension or stress that you have going on there. If it feels like your head is really hanging out in space too much, you could kind of fold or add a second blanket so you have a little bit more head support around. So I just put a tiny wrinkle in my blanket, just folded it a notch, and automatically that has made me feel a little more relaxed. It's elevated the back of my head a little bit. So you can experiment with that, and then come back to this idea of like releasing all this tissue around your head, and your ears, and your eyes. Let your mouth relax, and sometimes for me it's kind of awkward to figure out where to put my tongue, and what I do generally is I just let it hang out near the top of my upper palate, so kind of near my teeth. If it doesn't want to hang out there, you can see if there's another place that your tongue can just relax. Adjust the shoulder blades if it starts to feel like they relax differently. And then let the belly relax. If it feels like you're hardening at the hip or hardening across the belly, do support under your legs, because that'll help the belly relax and the hip flexors relax. And then let yourself breathe way down deep into the diaphragm. Stay for a bit. torso. Find yourself tensing up, or if anything gets a little fidgety, you can release or, you know, come out, take the blanket out from under you, for example. Or you can also consider just noticing that that is happening, and instead let yourself see if you can relax around it. Relax around the urge to fidget. Sometimes it's because we're really uncomfortable, and sometimes it's because we're used to fidgeting. The only way you'll know is to try not to. See what happens. Take a nice big breath. Now, we're going to come out of this by rolling gently to one side, taking our time. So I'm going to get my knees in a bent position, and then I'm rolling and rolling to my left, but you could roll either direction. And then you can either sit up to check out how the pose went, or you can lie down. So I'm going to lie down. So I'm taking the blanket out, and then I'm just going to come back onto my back for a moment. And the first thing that I want to check in every time I do a restorative pose, or yin, this is true in yin as well for me, but it's just to notice the impact that the pose had on me now that I'm no longer in it, right? So how does it feel in my body? Is the sensation of leaving the pose pleasant? Like, is there a nice pleasant aftertaste to the pose, or is it not so pleasant? Now there's some physical things that I feel, like I kind of feel that little impression left behind by the blanket, and sometimes it feels nice to me to do a little movement around that area, just kind of massage it. Or if I were seated, I might do some little cat-cow shapes just to kind of move that area a little bit. Actually, it feels nice to do cat-cows on the floor. Your pelvis back and forth, everything else will respond. Now, I also want to kind of check in to kind of overall state, and it feels for me like I have just sort of gently begun a sort of down regulation, like downshifting, right? My inner 1968 Corvette Stingray. Just kind of noticing this kind of overall sense of how the body or how your nervous system is responding. Now, we're going to do a little twist each side, but we're going to do this with support, so this is important. So I'm going to sit up, so I'm going to roll to my side again, and I'm going to sit up just so I can get my props in place, and then I'm going to lie back down. Okay. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use the blanket under my upper back. So the way I'm going to work with this, this is right now folded twice. I'm going to fold it one more time, longest edges together. And then I'm going to put that on the floor, and my head and shoulders are all going to rest on this. And so I want to make sure there aren't any wrinkles in it, and it's nice and smooth. So in the same way that when we practice vinyasa yoga, we want to pay attention to the alignment of, like, where does our knee go? Where do our feet go? Like, how does it orient with our hip? So that we don't injure ourselves. The alignment in restorative yoga is getting the props neat and tidy and all of the little bits worked out. That's our alignment in this particular case, okay? And then the pose is not being too spicy. Now I'm gonna lie down on my side, and I'm gonna get my legs in place, and then I'm gonna roll my upper back to the floor, okay? So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a pillow underneath the leg. I might wind up with a second pillow in between, but I'm going to leave that to the side for now, and then if I decide I want it, I will add it. And then I'm just going to let this top leg kind of come over the edge in a minute so that that will stabilize me. But for now, I just want to put those underneath and see if I can get my back all the way to the ground. And I might need to do some little fiddling. Okay, so I'm going to try to get all the way to the floor with my torso. And then I'm going to fiddle this. I need this guy to come in a little deeper. And then I can kind of scissor that leg over the top. And because that foot is hanging out, I'm going to put a pillow right in here to rest that foot on. Okay? So my goal with restorative yoga, as best I can, is not to have any body part hanging out in space. Everything's touching something. And so now I'm going to turn my head towards my feet. You could turn your head away from your feet. And if you're used to doing this pose without any props, do it with props just for fun. And maybe you don't have any pillows, so you use a bunch of blankets, or you use something else, a couch cushion off your couch, or whatever you got handy, okay? Now we're gonna stay with this pose only about 3 minutes, so it's not as long as the other one, but we'll do 3 minutes on each side. And you can turn your head all the way the other way if your neck is up for it. For me, usually my neck is really sensitive, I don't have a very long neck. And so my trapezius muscles and other muscles kind of get in the way a little bit for me. You may have a really long neck and you have a lot of room to rotate your vertebrae without any running into any muscle groups. So it might be better for you to have your head turned. All right, so I'm feeling like I'm gripping a little bit with my legs. So I'm gonna change this just a little bit. And I'm going to move this pillow a little bit lower, and I'm going to put this pillow right in the center. That's better. So I want to notice if I'm holding on, right? And sometimes that doesn't fly on my radar screen right away. Sometimes that shows up as a blip after I've been in the pose for a second. But as soon as you notice it, if something's like not quite right, adjust your props and see if you can find the spot where everything will relax and settle without your body having to grip tight to make it hold. And like maybe this shoulder's a little higher than the other. You can take your blanket and make a little fold. You may have to do a little smoothing, but you can actually rest your arm on that folded section. Okay, so you can get a little bit creative with your props to support all the body parts. One hand on my belly so I can just be present for that vayu, this swirling sensation of energy moving in my body, that kind of inhale, exhale flow. It's samana vayu. As our bodies drop into gravity, we might find like something that felt really good at the beginning doesn't feel as good. So like I moved my arm, right, for my last 30 seconds here because it just wasn't feeling as good as it did at the beginning. Poses are not necessarily static, but we don't want them to be overly fidgety. So we're going to take two more breaths. Grab this pillow so that as I take my top leg off of it, I can set it off to the side for a second, and then I'm going to take the other leg up, set that off to the side. Now, I'm not going to go anywhere in terms of my back, but I am going to just notice how I landed, right? How did I land in this pose? And is there a difference? Like, I can feel a slight difference in the way the sensation is in my two arms. Is there a difference in the sensation in my legs? If I extend my legs out, do I feel a difference? And there's this kind of really lovely sensation of the spine kind of still twisting for the first little bit. And that is slowly softening out, and I'm feeling like my hip return to the earth as my spine sort of unwinds the rest of the way, which is really fun. Now, I don't like to go immediately into the second twist because I want to let that kind of unwinding happen first. But usually that's about 30 seconds or so. We've gone for about a minute, so we're pretty ready. Maybe. So I'm going to put this pillow on the bottom, right? Because I'm going that way with my legs. I'm going to scooch over a little bit because I can get a little bit more room. And I'm going to keep this pillow handy. I don't know how I'm going to use it yet, but I probably will. So I'm going to take my legs over here. And again, I want to fiddle with it until it feels like my legs can relax and my upper back pretty well rests on this blanket, okay? Again, I can add little wrinkles. I can add a little wrinkle under my head, or I can even take one little section of this blanket and kind of tuck it in under my neck and make like a little, that feels kind of good, but like I can make like a little cave for my head, a little pod. You know, you can add some extra support. I'm gonna throw this guy in so that I can get my legs to really relax here in this support. So I have to grip. I have to come a little bit more towards this way. Okay, that's better. Sometimes for me, like throw pillows are a little bit awkward because they're floofy in the middle and they get really thin at the edges. And so sometimes the throw pillow for me is kind of like, well, what angle works best? Is it better if I have a diamond? Should I add, like, pull it toward me or push it away? So you might have to fiddle with that. And then I'm going to turn my head this way. We're going to stay for a few minutes. And again, once I get into the shape and I feel relatively stable, then my next task is just simply to unwind. Things become kind of flip onto my little radar screen. Oh, I might need to adjust that, or I might need to adjust that. Then I'll make little adjustments. And then come back to the sense of softening in, letting go. my last little bit. We've got another minute and a half or so here. So I can spend my last little bit really just with all the sensation focused on my breath. Because for the most part, my body is settled. Seconds with our pose here. Big breath. And then I brought my head back, and then I'm going to bring my leg back, and then the other leg back. And I'm going to set these pillows off to the side for now. And I'm going to pause and just give myself a chance to sort of rinse out and feel how that landed me. Now, we have one pose left. And I'm going to do this pose with my legs over the chair, which is a variation on Viparita Karani or legs up the wall. Now, the teacher who I first got introduced to this idea of, my restorative yoga teacher, Cora Wen, she calls this pose Instant Maui, which I think is hilarious. And I've also heard it called Stonehenge, which becomes obvious when you do it with bolsters and blocks instead of a chair. But in any case, what we're going to do is an inversion for our final pose. So I'm going to set myself up, taking my time. I'm going to bring this chair in so that it's positioned so that when I'm laying on my mat, I can put my legs up here. Now, for me, quite often, it's best for me to have my hips on something. So I'm going to use one of these throw pillows and put that on the floor, a little bit away from the chair. And basically, I'm just going to roll up onto this throw pillow. And I'm going to put my blanket up here so I have something to use for my head in a second. Okay, so I'm going to sit onto, I put my hip onto this throw pillow, and then I'm going to roll myself up just like I would up onto the wall, and then I'm going to adjust. Now, the reason I like the pillow is because I'm short. I'm average height for a girl, but, you know, for a chair, like, it's quite tall from here to here. I think these are made for people that are about 6'1". So, in any case, a little pillow under my hips gets my knees in the right spot so they land right on the base, okay? So if you don't need that, you have longer legs, you might be able to rest on the floor. Now, I've pulled this blanket up toward my head, and the open ends are up here. So I'm gonna take one end of this, half of this blanket, and I'm just gonna pull it in toward me. I'm not gonna lift my head, but I'm gonna pull this in and just nestle it under my neck. Okay, I'm making a pod or a little chamber for my head, a little soundproof chamber. Okay, so I pull it, and then I kind of tuck in the ends of this right under the edge of my neck. And then I'm going to take this last section and kind of wrap that over me so that it's a little bit darker. Now, not all blankets will follow all the way, and some may not go all the way over your eyeballs. But if you can get this little slight dark chamber, it's pretty nice. If you have an eye pillow, you can use that instead. And kind of tuck it in around your ears. This little blanket is finding me, but you can still make it happen. Okay. So now I've got like a little bit of a soundproof barrier for myself, and a little bit of light comes, it's a little darker. How's that? That's kind of nice. And once you've built your head pod and you've got your legs relaxed in whatever way works best, and if this doesn't work, just do Shavasana. It's delightful. And then we'll pause here for a few minutes. I have been known to stay in this for a solid 15 minutes, but for our purposes here today, we're gonna let ourselves kind of open up our pod. We're gonna take a nice deep breath. Now we're gonna go slow, you guys, because when your legs are up, your heart rate might drop a little. So we're gonna roll to the side, and I'm rolling over to my right side this time because that's the side that works best. And then I just pause for a couple breaths just to make sure that I'm not lightheaded. And then gently press yourself up. So that's our lunchtime restorative yoga. So just a little brief downshifting of the nervous system to give us a little break in the middle of the day, or whenever. You might do it at the end of your day instead. So let's have a nice big breath together. Big inhale. Big sigh. Namaste, yogi.